हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम समद। आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व गेट एरोस्पेस रॉकेट प्रोपल्शन क्वेश्चन व्हिच आस्क्ड इन 2008 एंड दिस पेपर हैड बीन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय IISc बेंगलोर। ओके, एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। इन अ कन्वर्जेंट डाइवर्जेंट नोजल ऑफ ए रॉकेट मोटर द वॉल हीट फ्लक्स इज मैक्सिमम 8। सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। ओके, सो एज वी नो दैट द कन्वर्जेंट डाइवर्जेंट नोजल। Okay, so this is the convergent divergent nozzle. Okay, this type of nozzle is there, and the wall heat flux is maximum at the exit of the divergent portion of the CD nozzle, the entry to the convergent portion of the CD, and the throat of the CD nozzle. This is the throat. Okay. This is the inlet and that is exit outlet. Okay, so here is the four option. So first of all, we know that if that is the wall heat flux is maximum, where is the wall heat flux is maximum? Okay, so in convergent divergent nozzle, Mach number increases continuously. So if Mach number will be increasing, okay, so temperature will be decrease. We have to know these rules. Okay, Mach number increase, I'm just writing here like that. Mach number increase, then temperature will be decrease. Okay, and heat flux formula is like that. Q is equal to K into T minus T naught divided by T, and that T is the thickness. Okay, so Q, that is the heat flux, is directly proportional to temperature. So if temperature is here is decreasing, then heat flux will be decreasing. So maximum heat flux is in the beginning, that is inlet, because at the exit temperature decrease and at the inlet temperature will be higher. Okay, so for inlet temperature is higher, then Q is higher, that is heat flux will be higher. So at the inlet, the heat flux will be maximum at the inlet. So here is the B is the right answer. The entry to the convergent portion of this CD nozzle, entry portion. Okay, at T is the thickness. If T is increases, then heat flux also decreases. Okay, sometime can be asked in this type of question, if thickness is increased, then heat flux should be decreased. Okay, that is the indirectly proportional to thickness. So this is the B answer for this question. Now move to third question. In third question, the chamber stagnation temperature inside a rocket motor is TC. Okay, that is a TC, the chamber temperature is given. Only a convergent nozzle is used and the flow at the exit of this nozzle choked. Assume that is the choking condition is given. Okay, nozzle choked. So nozzle choking is M equal to 1. Okay, for nozzle choking. Okay, so now assume that the nozzle exhaust static pressure is equal to that ambient static pressure. Gas constant for exhaust gas is R is given, and the ratio of the specific heat is given, that is the all term is given with four lines. The specific impulse of the rocket is, so I have to find out what is the specific impulse. Okay, there is the four option is given. So if M is equal to 1, then V E, that is the V star equal to A star, nothing but the under root gamma R T star. Okay, so as you know that the what is specific impulse? So specific impulse is equal to thrust divided by mass flow rate. This is nothing but the thrust formula is mass flow rate into VE divided by mass flow rate. Okay, that is VE. So specific impulse is equal to exit velocity. Okay, and exit velocity formula is under root gamma R T naught. Okay. Actually, gamma r t star. Okay, so just we apply this formula gamma r t star for choked flow, and we just multiply with t naught and divided by t naught. Okay, so it becomes like that. We can write now like this: gamma r t naught and into t star divided by t naught, and t star divided by t naught is equal to what? 2 by gamma plus 1 under root gamma r t naught into 2 by gamma plus 1. I can write, so is equal to under root 2 gamma r t naught is nothing but the tc. Okay, t naught tc is the chamber temperature, divided by gamma plus 1, that is nothing but the specific impulse. So if you see in the formula, okay, so d is the right answer here, because you will see 2 gamma r tc divided by gamma plus 1. Okay, so d is the right option for this question. Now we will see the fourth question. The initial temperature sensitivity of the burn rate of a solid rocket motor propellant is positive if the initial temperature increase. So initial temperature increase, then burn rate will be increased. Okay, that is the relation. So if initial temperature increase, burn rate increase, then burn time will be decreased, and when burn time will be decreased, then thrust will be increased. Thrust will be increased. Okay, and that is the relation for that. Okay, that is the burn time, that is the r dot. Okay, burn rate, and ti is the initial temperature, and that is the thrust. That is that four relation we have to remember. Okay, so using this relation we get the option is thrust increase but the burn time decrease. Okay, so A is the right option. Okay, if initial temperature increase, then thrust increases but burn time will decrease. Now we will see this question. Okay, that is the common data type for question. Okay, so a liquid rocket engine with oxidizer to fuel ratio, oxidizer to fuel ratio is given 5:1, produces a thrust 1 MN. The initial mass of rocket engine is, that is m naught is given. Okay, and its mass at burn out is, that is the burn out mass, that is nothing but the final mass. Mf is the final mass. Okay, 10,000 kg. The characteristics velocity c and the thrust coefficient cf for the engine r, that is c star, and c star is given 2386, and the cf, that is thrust coefficient, is given 1.4. the mass flow rate of the fuel, so I have to find out mass flow rate. Okay, so how to find out mass flow rate? So using this data we have to find out mass flow rate. As you know that ISP is equal to C star into CF. This is the formula actually, and ISP formula is also F divided by, F is nothing but the thrust divided by mass flow rate. Okay, so here thrust is given 1 MN. Okay, thrust is given 1 MN, and C star CF also given. So just that is 2386 multiplied by 1.4 is equal to F, that is 1 MN, 1 × 10⁶ N divided by mass flow rate. Okay, using this we can find out mass flow rate, दैट इज टोटल मास फ्लो रेट, ओके 299 डिवाइडेड बाय सॉरी 299.365, 365 इज द मास फ्लो रेट, एंड एज यू नो दैट टोटल मास फ्लो रेट, दैट इज टोटल मास फ्लो रेट इज मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ ऑक्सीडाइजर प्लस मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ फ्यूल. सो मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ ऑक्सीडाइजर बाय फ्यूल इज 5:1, दैट इज मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ ऑक्सीडाइजर इज 5 into मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ फ्यूल. यू कैन राइट लाइक दिस यूजिंग दिस रिलेशन, प्लस मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ फ्यूल एंड टोटल मास इज आई जस्ट गॉट 299.365. ओके सो यूजिंग दिस यू कैन फाइंड आउट मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ फ्यूल. सो मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ फ्यूल इज इक्वल टू 49.894 केजी पर सेकेंड. ओके 49.89. सो हियर इज द 49.9 केजी, दैट इज द डी इज द राइट आंसर. ओके ओके नाउ वी विल सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नेग्लेक्टिंग ग्रेविटी एंड ड्रैग इफेक्ट, इफ द इनिशियल वेलोसिटी ऑफ द लिक्विड रॉकेट इंजन इज, व्हाट इज द इनिशियल वेलोसिटी इज गिवन 2.5 किलोमीटर पर सेकेंड, द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द रॉकेट बर्न आउट इज. ओके सो वी हैव फॉर्मूला डेल वी इज इक्वल टू वी एफ माइनस वी इनिशियल वी आई इज इक्वल टू वी इक्विवेलेंट इंटू एल एन ऑफ इनिशियल मास डिवाइडेड बाई फाइनल मास. ओके सो इज देयर गिवेन, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द वेलोसिटी ऑफ रॉकेट एट द बर्न आउट, वी एफ आई हैव टू फाइंड आउट. ओके सो वी एफ माइनस इनिशियल इज गिवेन 2.5 किलोमीटर पर सेकेंड. ओके सो आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज द यूनिट. इक्विवेलेंट वी इक्विवेलेंट इज गिवेन, वी इक्विवेलेंट इज नॉट गिवेन, सो वी कैन फाइंड आउट यूजिंग अबव ऑल डाटा इज गिवेन. ओके सो हाउ टू फाइंड आउट वी इक्विवेलेंट, सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट वी इक्विवेलेंट इज इक्वल टू थ्रस्ट डिवाइडेड बाय मास फ्लो रेट. ओके सो 10^6 डिवाइडेड बाय मास फ्लो रेट इज 299.365. ओके सो 3340.4 मीटर पर सेकेंड इज द वी इक्विवेलेंट. सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू राइट 3340.4 एल एन इनिशियल मास इज गिवन 100,000 एंड फाइनल मास इज गिवन 1,000. फाइनल मास इज दैट इज द फाइनल मास, एक्चुअली फाइनल मास इज गिवन बर्न आउट फाइनल मास 10,000 इज गिवन. ओके सो हियर वी विल जस्ट राइट द फाइनल मास 10,000. Okay, now solving this equation, we just get a final velocity. Final velocity is 10.19 kilometer per second. Okay, so in this question, C is the right answer. 10.2, almost 10.2 kilometer per second. Okay, so that question has been completed. Now one more question is there. DB denotes the double base solid propellants. Okay, LOX-RP1 denotes the liquid oxygen kerosene combination, LOX-LH2 denotes the liquid oxygen hydrogen combination. The correct order of increasing a specific impulse. So if you know the what is the specific impulse of liquid oxygen RP1, liquid oxygen LH2 and double base solid propellant, so you can easily find out the option given. Okay, so first of all we have to remember that a specific impulse is lower for solid propellant always. Okay, For solid propellant, specific impulse is lower if you compare to liquid propellant. Also, hydrocarbons have lower specific impulse than liquid hydrogen. Okay, so right option is this one, because we have two writing in increasing order. So double base solid is the much less than the less than specific impulse we compared to LOX RP1. Okay, and this is less than the LOX liquid oxygen with LH2 hydrocarbons. Okay, so A is the right option. So all question we are asking in 2008 has been solved in this videos. Bye bye.